The year, 1967. The place, Montreal. It was here that Expo 67 took place, a showcase for big screen films. It was also here that three men's paths would cross, resulting in the birth of IMAX. Graham Ferguson and Robert Kerr had gone to high school together in the small town of Galt, Ontario. The two friends had co-produced a film called Polar Life for the Expo. Roman Kreuter was also a filmmaker, and he produced the film Labyrinth for the Montreal Expo. The three men observed that the audiences loved the big screen films and the immersion that the larger screen provided. But they weren't perfect. At this time, multiple projectors were needed to produce the larger image, which was a technical nightmare as all the projection equipment needed to be perfectly synchronized. Using multiple projectors also meant that the image was never seamless. Ferguson thought to himself that they ought to be looking for a way to make these films without multiple projectors. Such an opportunity arose when the Fuji Group asked Kreuter to make a large-screen film for Expo 70 in Japan. Kreuter managed to convince the group to provide funding to develop a new system for showing large-screen films. He also invited Ferguson and Kerr to work with him, and in September 1967, the three men incorporated Multi-Screen Corporation, whose name would later be changed to IMAX. The concept for IMAX was to use 70mm, horizontally oriented film instead of the standard 35mm vertical film. This produced an image with 9 times more detail than the standard 35mm and 3 times more detail than the existing 70mm film, which, like its 35mm counterpart, was also oriented vertically. To make and show movies in this new, larger format, a new camera and projection system was needed. The camera was designed easily by Norwegian inventor Jan Jacobsen in only 2.5 months, but the projector turned out to be a much more difficult problem. In a normal movie projector, film is pulled down through the projector at 24 frames per second. But for the IMAX film to be shown at 24 frames per second, the film must be pulled through the projector much faster because of the larger size and horizontal orientation. Running the 70mm film through a projector at 24 frames per second would tear the perforations and shred the film. To solve this technical challenge and design the projection system, the IMAX team hired Bill Shaw, an engineer who was also from Galt and had attended high school with Ferguson and Kerr. To solve the issue of the tearing perfs, IMAX bought a patent for a rolling loop projector, a design which they believed would help ease the large film through the projector without damaging it. Shaw adapted the rolling loop design for the larger film, and after some initial difficulties, he managed to get the projector working on time for Expo 70. After Expo 70, the projector was bought by Ontario Place, a government-sponsored theme park in Toronto. This became the first permanent IMAX theater, and Ontario Place also paid IMAX to produce the first film for the new theme park, called North of Superior. Over the years, IMAX has developed new technologies such as digital remastering and digital 3D IMAX cameras, but nothing can match the spectacular quality of their original 70mm film process. If you enjoyed this video, then you should consider checking out some of my other content, and be sure to subscribe so you don't miss a future video.